have two guns. We have two guns, a book, and hopefully a flag of Boko Haram. Similarly looks like the ISIS stuff. And Western education should not be allowed. This is said by Boko Haram, and not only one person, but not only the group, but said by one person, Abu Bakr Shekau. They actually don't want Western education to be allowed in the northern part of Nigeria, because they think Western education will take away things and kind of people will digress from being people will digress from the Islamic way of life and focus more on education. So they don't want Western education in the whole part of West Africa. Actually, West Africa is in chaos right now, majorly Nigeria. Now, today I'm talking about Boko Haram, northern part of Nigeria, and the abducted girls. Some girls were abducted. So, okay, so firstly, Boko Haram. Boko Haram, which calls itself Wilayat Garb Ifraqiya and Jamaat al-Ashshuni Lid Diwa, those are Arabic stuff. And it's an Islamic extremist group based in the northern eastern part of Nigeria, also called, and also active, sorry, in Chad. Chad is closer to Nigeria. It's like Lake Chad. This is Chad up there, then down in Nigeria. So they come mainly from Chad, and they get into Nigeria. So they come via Niger and northern Cameroon. The founder of this group is Mohammed Yusuf, founded 2002. Maiduguri, Nigeria. Headquarters is in Maiduguri, also in Nigeria. And they have two leaders, Mohammed Yusuf and Abu Bakr Shekau. That's their names. So, this is Abu Bakr Shekau, the one holding the paper. This Islamic group, they're very, 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 very dangerous. And they actually made Nigerians scared of their own shadows. And when I talk about that, I mean the northern part of Nigeria was in so much chaos that people were scared of the Islamic people, and I mean it was just so devastating, very devastating. So basically people thought that, okay, fine, because they started and they were going into churches. I mean several kind of things happened. People were in the church service, the next thing you know is gunmen. They just enter the church and kill everybody and make sure everybody's dead. In the northern part, and they started with just. So they went into several churches and killed people. But people were like, oh, fine, these people are going into churches. Whoa, that means the Islamic group are like onto Christians, right? So we were wrong. People that actually thought it that way were very, very wrong. So the next thing we heard on the news was Boko Haram entering the mosque, and the next thing they killed the Imam Afaz, the priest. I mean, why would Muslim attack a Muslim? That was so crazy. So people actually thought, okay, fine, now this is getting crazy. Now, the next thing that happened was that Muslims and Christians joined together. Now, if you look at that image, you see Muslims and Christians holding their temples, and the devil is in the middle trying to, you know, poke around. So, actually, we worked together to do this. Now, this is an animation stuff. I picked it up on the net, and I think it was really, really cool. And this is Abu Bakr Shekau saying, I see a woman. Now, we're going into that kind of phase where the abducted women were. So these are the group, the Islamic group, waving their flags. And their aim is to put their flags everywhere in Nigeria and take over Nigeria and turn Nigeria to an Islamic state, which will not be possible by the grace of God. Now, northern part of Nigeria, this is Nigeria, you understand? So, that is, this is the northern part of Nigeria, and we have Sokoto, Maiduguri, Kaduna, Abuja, I mean, so many states I could mention for it, but you don't know it because that's my country. Now, I'm from this part of Nigeria, and it's really, really safe. The places that are in green are really, really bad and a no-go area. Like, people don't go there. People are actually running away from there. People that are from the northern part of Nigeria actually come to Lagos, come to so many places, and we are by the, I think this is the North Pacific Ocean, I don't even know, but this place is safe. Now let me be fast. Okay, now people actually thought that the Boko Haram, you know, I mean, they're a terrorist group, right? And we all know about ISIS, Middle East, Iraq, Iran, they're taking over everywhere, and the ISIS people, they say they moved up to, they put their flag on Buckingham Palace, on White Flag, White House. That's not going to be possible. So this is the ISIS group. People believe that the ISIS group and Boko Haram, they're working together. And similarly, if you heard me in the beginning, I said their flags are almost the same, which is true. It's the jihad group, they, Muhammad, Yusuf, Abubakar, they all work together to like, they go from Shad to different kind of places and they bring in terrorist people. And they're also recruiting people, which is so crazy. Now, Boko Haram abducts girls. Now, if you look at this picture, we have like almost 200 girls. If I'm not mistaken, 180 something girls. I don't think it's up to 200 girls. Well, so this happened last year. I was still in Nigeria. So this happened last year, and what happened was that the next thing on the news was that they went into schools and they abducted 200 girls. How would that be possible? Like, were there no securities and everybody around? So this thing is also trying to digress and also like move into the aspect of they working with the government. Because how would 200 girls be abducted without people not even knowing where they took? And there was something that came up. People were like, okay, fine, these girls are in the place called Shibok. It's a jungle, and that's where they hid all these girls. You can see the background, bushes, trees, dry land and weeds, grasses. That's it. So these people, these girls, they made them pregnant or whatever they want to do with them. They can marry them, whatever. They just put up pictures, post it on the internet and say, now we have the girls. Then you see Abubakar Shekar reading the book, quoting his Islamic stuff. Then the next thing, we hear that some girls ran away. But actually, in the news, five girls ran away and they were actually safe. But I mean, each time they come on the news, they kind of censor their face so people won't notice them. And they said that most girls died while trying to run away. So some of the girls are pregnant right now. Some might have actually put to bed. All right, so now the girls, I just told you about that. So, okay, let's go. All right, now the Bring Back Our Girls campaign was last year. Bring Back Our Girls campaign started last year, and it was also hashtag Bring Back Our Girls. And most people actually did this. It went around the whole world. It went viral. If you heard it, I don't know. But it went really, really viral. And the next picture you see is Obama's wife. She said, Bring Back Our Girls, to put the old stuff. And people from all over the world, Bring Back Our Girls. Till now, the girls are still being held captive. So the world can be a better place, I believe. Do you? Thank you.